This one gives you fishing. Give it to this guy. Okay, we're running out. Good. Thank goodness. I think this guy could use some physical attacks, so we'll give him that as well. Although, actually... see, whoever has no elemental attack, then he gonna get... Yeah, okay, so Wozniak the Protector, he's gonna need a lot of stuff, actually. Does he have a shoe, I wonder? I don't think he does. Oh, really? This thing is a head ornament? Okay. You already have a shoe. Where is he? Oh, you don't. Okay, congratulations, you get a shoe. Finally, that was a ton of items. So is this gonna happen every time we kill a hero? That's ridiculous. But overall, I mean, it's good that they have a bunch of abilities, but man. I mean, a little bit of moderation would be nice. Actually, we do have an inn here. I wonder if we can hire something. Let's give it a try. A dwarf firstborn. Do I want this thing? Spearman is actually better. Halfling adventurer. It's one of my least favorite units. You know what? I'll take it. At this point, we'll take anything. So we have a small nymph army going on. Yeah, you guys just hang out there. Alright, do we want to build anything here whatsoever? I think the observatory here would be useful. Get more territory. Try to improve the halfling village here somehow. Alright, so the big question here is, can we last 7 turns? If we can last 7 turns while controlling the seals, we can actually win the game. I don't care if we lose all the cities, all the villages. If we just keep holding on to these 2 seals, we'll be fine. We just have to withstand the onslaught that is coming our way from like 3 different wizards. And we did build a bunch of cities, so I guess that kind of helps. You know, it provides a bunch of distractions, which is convenient. So we have like four poor armies there. Could use another one. Next turn we'll be able to summon the what's his face, the Horned God. So yeah, we're gonna save this mana for now. Oh, now we have the race governance. Why? Thank you. Lucky clover fields in the domain of halflings gained whatever. Now we do have an eagle rider, so you know what? I'm gonna take that. Oops. Very likely victory, he says. Okay. It seems this is the only seal which is spawning stuff towards us. All the others are kind of neutral. Okay, this is a very bad spawning spot. I don't know why they keep spawning like this. And there's just way too many of them, all of a sudden. That is quite a lot. I think we might lose a few units here. Yeah, you guys need to get away from this place. Just run away. I wonder. Hornet swarm. Does it have any effect? Actually, it does have an effect. Surprisingly, some of them have a weakness towards it. Yeah, the Earth and the Holy Elemental, they have a weakness towards that, so it's nice. We're gonna try and make sure that they get hit first, as much as possible. Is it possible to hit like 5 of them instead of just 4? Have some of that. See what they do. Oh, they can heal? Huh? Okay, the monkeys got struck. I think we have another hero here. Oh, there's no hero nearby. Never mind, it's the only one. He's not affected, really? They can be entangled though, surprisingly. I guess we'll give it a try. Of course it didn't work. Of course. I mean, at this point it doesn't matter, we just throw everything we got at these guys. He has frost aura. Well, my mammoth has some frost resistance, this might help. Good, that's a lot of damage. Perfect. Rush. Man, does their retaliation have to be so, so ridiculously powerful? Oh, they also have, like, protection against us? That's just great. That's exactly what we need. Let's see what units we're gonna lose. So our elephant miraculously managed to survive. We're gonna try to heal him, actually. Or at least kill somebody. Wow, this is hard. Alright, this guy's dead. It's kind of funny, the AI likes to sort of put status effects on you, so they... So they try to freeze armor units instead of just killing them directly. I mean, those frost elementals, they could have actually killed some of my units there, but they instead decided to apply some weird frost effects or whatever. And of course that backfired. And we lost no one. How about that? Okay. Very likely victory, it says. This time we have two heroes, so it should be indeed very likely. So, you see, this is what I don't like about CL victories, is that they can get extremely intense all of a sudden. And, like, everyone is attacking you, including these elementals, so unless you have some really good combat, you're not probably... it's probably not gonna go your way. I wonder, do we have some good spells here? No, you don't have any Mass Effect spells. What about you? Oh, you do. You probably have a Hornet Swarm. There we go. Of course it can't affect one. Of course it can't. We're gonna have to tough it out, unfortunately. They have like a genuine Earth Elemental there. These guys have 100% light protection. It's not gonna be very good, is it? You can only cast this on Frostlings, I assume. Yeah. We don't have any Frostling here, so we cannot cast the Frozen Flame. Wait, actually we can. Frozen Flames can be cast on anybody. Let's cast it on the spider, shall we? She can't teleport, but at least she can stay alive with the Vampire. She has the Fine Bar Touch. Lifesteal, yeah. 3 to 5 health every time she performs an attack, which is very useful. It seems we have a lot of melee units here, and there's like 2 fire elementals, which doesn't help at all. Good, if we manage to reduce his movement, that's actually for the best. Guys need you as well. Too far away. Maybe we should have ran away before instead of engaging them directly. And maybe try to gather the rest of our army. These guys never seem to make it into the fight. They always arrive late to the party. Well anyway, next turn they're gonna be there, so it's fine. Wow, they have a very tough physical attack. 20 damage melee strike. Really? How am I supposed to kill this thing? Blight weakness and shock weakness. We don't have any shock weapons. We have shock serpents, and even they can't deal too much damage. So, really, what can we do? Alright, you have blight weakness. I guess the spider can be effective against you. Okay, let's give it a try. That's it. Really? The only unit which has a blight weakness fumbled the attack. That is ridiculous. Oh god, man, that is just annoying. I probably should have moved him elsewhere, but why did I move him here? Anyway, this guy's probably gonna die, so whatever. Dealt 2 damage to his neighbor. Very nice synergy, you guys. I mean, you're really nailing it. Can we web him? They can be webbed. Looks like web was buffed. Previously, you can't web these guys. Excuse me. Wow. Oh man. Getting a little sneezy there. Can you cast any spells by any chance? Shock missile. Well, there we go. That's all that. We can try entangling this bastard. Although it works better on that. Can we set fire to him? No. Anyway, this hero's probably gonna die, so... yes, enjoy. I don't wanna risk the shock serpent here, so we're just gonna leave them for now. Oh, hang on, we actually have another hero. Can do a decent attack. We're gonna try the Assassin's Strike, see if that works. It works beautifully, but it's just not strong enough. We also have a Mammoth. I'm gonna kill this one first. Add Noxious Vulnerability. This is brutal. This is brutal stuff. Oh, God. Ridiculous. Can we at least, like, kill this one guy? There we go. And he has regrowth. That's just beautiful. Alright. Lost a hero. It's not a permanent loss. He will come back. Finally. If there's anybody who has a frost attack, I guess what you might work. You know, this is the worst time for you to fumble attacks. Don't do that again. Anyway. Oh, we can kill it. Unless it fumbles. Which it did. Of course it did. Let's try this guy. Oh, there we go. Okay, so the hero's back. See, that's not a permanent loss there. We managed to defend this place. It's like an endless stream of challenges. It's very stressful. Who's next? Poison Domain. Not interested. Maybe Druidry, actually. Let's take Druidry, because at this point, we're kind of on the defensive, so that Druidry is really good on the defensive. People are capturing seals everywhere. Like, why are they fighting me? Why don't they fight each other? Although, to be fair, I am kind of the closest to victory at this point. So, yeah, 5 turns and we win, ladies and gentlemen. Enjoy the show. This guy has like 2. He's a bit of a lucky bastard. He actually started like on the edge of the map, whereas I'm like in the center. And we'd like have to deal with everybody simultaneously. Right. 7 points. Definitely healing. Can I give you healing? What was that? Right, we're waiting for the turn to process. Hang on. Right, so you do have healing and nourishing meal. You have a bunch of healing buffs so far. So now you have 3 points. Shall we give you with these? Sustainable warfare, what is this? All units in the hero's army gain the volunteer ability. Units with a volunteer require 50% less upkeep. But it only affects gold upkeep, and right now we have a lot of summoned units. So how does that work exactly? I guess we keep 3? Yeah, we'll keep them. We're getting domain invasions up the ass at this point. How am I supposed to deal with this thing? We're gonna keep, like, dealing with these random units dropping by and causing trouble. Actually, you're here. You should be able to defend this place. Oh, so these guys have been affected by the plague. And it has been super enforced. God, man. Sometimes, you know, the AI in this game really can throw some shit at you. I mean, God, that is just ridiculous. Do we want these guys to join? Well, actually, I don't care about you guys anymore. There's a domain invasion there. Where is it? Did we just kill these guys? Maybe it's the giants, like they dropped in and came out again. I don't know. There's supposed to be like a domain invasion, but I don't see it. I guess I can do some scouting. Let's just check this place out. You have some good movement. Let's see. I don't see anybody, so yeah, let's just head back home. Oh, ah, what is this? It has lesser flying. They can fly during the tactical map. They don't have embarkation. And, oh, they are embarked. So they do have some reduced defense, but they still have this massive melee strike. Which means... But you know what we can do? We can still sort of try to attack them somehow. With our fantastic baby Krakens there. Closely matched, it says. I don't think it's actually closely matched. I think we're probably gonna lose this, but we're gonna give it a try anyways. And if we can kill like a couple of units, that would be also great. Of course, it also depends on what kind of magic they use. Fire. You know, this is the worst time possible for you to fumble your attacks, for God's sake. Alright, this has to hit. If this gets fumbled... Thank God. Alright. We can also attack that one over there. Ouch. This one is a bit tougher. Alright, let's see what happens next. Now this one of them is gonna die for sure. Oops. Yeah, so the Sun Disc pretty much destroyed my army here. Oh, they also have First Strike? That's just wonderful. You know, that really... That really makes us happy, you know what I mean? But hey, at least we destroyed 2 of their units. Anything to whittle them down, I guess. Any other Sun Disc shenanigans you got? Of course you do. Okay. Well, at least we managed to kill two of theirs, and yeah, they're kind of forcing the defensive now. And now we have some mana freed up to summon some other cool stuff. Like, let's say, the Horned God, for example. It's gonna take 4 turns, but it's worth it. Actually, how much upkeep does this guy cost? 36 upkeep per turn. What? Well, we definitely need more mana then. Some emergency mana. Give me a shrine. What the hell is this? Where did this thing come from now? I wonder if these spiders are gonna end up killing these. That would be kinda sad. I mean, I put a lot of money into protecting them and such. Anyway, yeah, so 5 turns until we win. There's a bunch of people lighting their beacons and all that crap. How many beacons have been lighted so far? Let me double check. She's constructing a tower. Yeah, so she's quite close. She's still constructing this. It still has to be lit. I think we should be able to manage. Destroy the tower before the ritual can be completed. So it's a bit clunky there. And yeah, this... The debuffs it's having on us are just brutal. You know, at this point it's just absolutely ridiculous. I mean, it's bad enough that they're already winning the game, but now we have to deal with this nonsense. Like, why don't they attack each other? And destroy each other's beacons? Why is the AI just attacking me? That just makes no sense. Anyway, so yeah, so far it's been a very stressful few episodes here, but I'm having a lot of fun, surprisingly. I don't think we can win this, honestly. I mean, I have the odds that we actually make it out of this alive are just very low. Because at some point, these sun discs, these massive Sphinx units are just going to come in. They're going to crash in, they're going to burn all my units here, and I don't think we can sustain, continue surviving like this. And we're going to lose cities one by one, by the way, so which means our economy is going to be tanking. There's a plague here, there's this one lonely hero. I don't think he can, like, defend this area for very long. They have a couple heroes down there, actually. But if you have any hope for this playthrough whatsoever, tune in next time, where we hopefully spend the next 4 turns just holding out, enduring one combat after another, and maybe possibly winning. This is going to be a very early victory, actually. Turn 77, very, very fast victory there. So that would be impressive. That would be a first for me. I usually win like around like 100 or something, 90 something turns usually. Unity beacon victories, conquest victories take much longer. So there we go. So yeah, thank you all for watching. This was very enjoyable. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have any suggestions, any ideas, any complaints about my playstyle, any mistakes that I've been doing, feel free to leave a comment.